That's right. So, in the previous class, we have finished about basics in pictures. Hope you have revised enough and you know solved all your doubts. So, coming to the next two topics are remaining. So, once we finish these two chapters, these topics, chapter will be over. Yes. The two topics are, yes, one is electrical properties and the next one is magnetic properties of solids. So, the topic is electrical properties of solids. Electrical properties of solids. Yes. So, what are the electrical properties of solids that we are going to learn here? Based on the magnitude of conductivity. So, based on magnitude of conductivity. Magnitude of conductivity, conductivity value. Solids are classified into three types. So you all know very well, that is conductors, then semiconductors, and the next one is insulators. Conductor, semiconductor, and insulators. Yes. What is the definition of these all? Yes, as we see that which pass current is called as conductor, which do not pass current called insulator and semiconductor. But that is not the correct definition. We have to discuss based on the magnitude of conductivity. If the conductivity range is 10 power 4 to 10 power 7 ohm inverse meter inverse, if that, this is the conductivity range, 10 power 4 to 10 power 7 ohm inverse meter inverse, then it is called as conductors. Yes, example, all metals as well as ionic compounds in molten state, all ionic compounds but in molten state, they are the examples for conductors. Now, what do you mean by semiconductors whose range is 10 power minus 6 to 10 power 4 ohm inverse meter inverse? This is a conductivity range. 10 power minus 6 to 10 power 4 ohm inverse meter inverse, they are called as semiconductor. Example, silicon, germanium, etc. Now, what do you mean by insulator whose conductivity range is 10 power minus 20 to 10 power minus 10 ohm inverse meter inverse? They are called as insulators. So, example, all covalent compounds, or you can say diamond, etc. So it's about based on the magnitude of conductivity, we classify the compounds into three types: conductor, semiconductor, and insulator. Now, what is the reason? We should learn why some compound behave as conductor, why some other as semiconductor, and some as insulator. So we should see the reasons here. So reasons is explained based on band theory. It is a physics topic and it is there in chemistry also. It is a band theory of solids. So band theory of solids is there to explain the electrical properties of solids. According to band theory of solids, each solid has two bands. Each solid has two bands. One is valency band, and another one is conduction band. Yes, valency band and conduction band. What is the meaning of these? Valency band is made up of fully occupied, electron occupied molecular orbital. So you must have studied MO theory, molecular orbital theory. So in there, the highest electron occupied molecular orbital, highest electron occupied molecular orbital is called as a valency band, and the lowest electron unoccupied molecular orbital is called as a conduction band. So in short, if you are confused, I will tell you simple thing. The valency band is full of electrons. Valency bond is band is full of electrons, and the conduction band is empty band. So here it is say that U stands for what? Unoccupied. Electron unoccupied molecular orbital means empty band. O stands for what? Electron occupied molecular orbital. So this is a full of electron and that is a empty band. Now the energy gap between these two, the energy gap symbol EG between valency band and conduction band will decide the nature of compound. If the energy gap is very less, then electron will easily flow from valency band to conduction band. Yes, you can see, I'll show you the figure. In the case of conductor, what happened? In the case of conductor, this is valency band, which is full of electrons, and this is conduction band, is the empty band. So I use abbreviation CB. CB means conduction band, and this is VB, means valency band. Here both the bands are overlapping into each other, so electron can easily move from valency band to conduction band and it acts as conductor. So here both bands overlap into each other. So then that is called as conductor. Then what do you mean by semiconductor? What do you mean by semiconductor? So in semiconductor, there is a small energy gap between valency band. It is a valency band, and this is conduction band. This is valency band, and this is conduction band. And here, there is a small energy gap. So only few electrons can jump. Only few electrons having sufficient energy can jump from valency band to conduction band, and that is acting as semiconductor. But how much energy gap? You are telling small energy gap. There should be some magnitude. The magnitude you will learn in physics. So we can what is the value of that all things. So here we can see that small energy gap between valency band and conduction band. So due to this, only few electrons can jump from valency band to conduction band. It acts as a semiconductor. The next one is insulator. So insulator, what do you mean by insulator? Here, this is, as we say, valency band, and the conduction band. There is a large energy gap. This is conduction band. So the energy gap is large. Large energy gap between valency band and conduction band. This large energy gap is also known as forbidden gap. It is also known as forbidden energy gap. So if that much energy gap is there, then only few electrons, no electron can jump from valency band to conduction band. So that means electron movement is not possible, so it acts as insulator. This is about band theory of solids. I repeat, according to band theory of solid, each solid has two bands, valency band and conduction band. Valency band is made up of, or is a composition of, highest electron occupied molecular orbital. Electron occupied, it means it is a full of electrons. Conduction band is made up of those molecular orbitals which having the lowest electron unoccupied molecular orbital, means it is the empty band. It is a full of electrons, It is empty band. Now the energy gap between, the energy gap between valency band and conduction band will decide the nature of the compound. If the energy gap is less, or you can say overlap, they overlap into each other, then it acts as conductor. If there is a small energy gap between these two, then it acts as semiconductor. If forbidden energy gap means very large energy gap, then it acts as insulator. So this is all about electrical properties of solids and band theory of solids. Now we have discussed detail about semiconductors. So you can take note of it. Then we will move to the next one. Right. So now the next one is semiconductors. So we should discuss in detail about semiconductors. Yes. Now the next topic is in these electrical properties only, that is semiconductors. Semiconductors. What do you mean by semiconductor? Semiconductor means any compound whose conductivity range is, we have studied just now, conductivity ranges, whose the conductivity range is 10 power minus 6 to 10 power 4 ohm inverse meter inverse. They are called as semiconductors. Or you can have other definition also. So, or they act as, the solids which act as insulator at 0 Kelvin temperature and act as conductor at a high temperature. So they are called as we can say semiconductor. So it means at 0 Kelvin temperature they are behaving as insulator. Right? When the temperature is increased, then they act as conductor. They are also called as semiconductor. Now, how to increase the conductivity of temperature? So, I mean the conductivity of semiconductors. The conductivity of semiconductors can be increased by two ways. One is by increasing temperature. How increasing temperature will increase the conductivity? Suppose you take pure silicon, how many valence electrons are there around each silicon? You must be knowing silicon belongs to group number 14, so there are 4 electrons around each silicon. It goes on. So octet will be completely fulfilled. Now there is no free electron. Here you can see no free electron. All the 8 electrons are occupied. Now when temperature is increased, bonds get broken. So it means somewhere if the bond is broken. Here you can see the bond is broken and here the electrons are generated, free electrons. So bond is broken and free electrons